And we're back to learning Inkscape, and this time I'm going to show you how to apply the basic textures to text in Inkscape. We've got a couple of texture filters, one-click effects, most of them. Let us pick one. For example, the bark. I'll zoom in. As I said, it's a one-click effect, which goes for most of these texture filters. And some of them create quite complex results, like this one. I personally like this one, the whittled effect. The only one that you can adjust via menu is the ink blot. I've made a specific video about that. You will find that in the description below. The other ones, they can be adjusted with the image effects sharpen and sharpen more. So if you add that to your text before you apply a filter or afterwards, you can adjust it a little bit. Let me apply this one. It's fine. You can see when I move it, it's reapplied. It's because of the sharpening effect. So simply moving it around adjusts it. Another way to adjust it is to just copy it by pressing Ctrl D and layering it on top of each other. It creates different effects as well. If you now add the image effects sharpen, you can see that it's also applied to the other ones. It's because we've got it copied. So if you really want to have different results for the same filter, you should just copy the text before you apply the filter. So let me show you this with the whittled effect. So I apply it again to the right hand side. And if I now add the image sharpening effect, the one on the left is not affected. But if I copy the one on the right that already has the whittled filter and then apply the sharpening, it's also applied to the one above. For some effects, if you just copy them and layer them on top of each other, it doesn't have an impact. So that's also something that you need to consider. But this is how you can use these general texture filters in Inkscape and apply them to text. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.